Itself over the ones I loved. The ship broke up under them. The ship that had sailed from a land of shining fields. Their memorial stone is sacred. Come not here in the sun. Come not with a sword. Come not crying over a naked corpse. Come not with disturbed mind.
Do you hear the suffering, Senua? Does your precious gift of sight let you see the souls that rot here in this sea of corpses? Do you feel the blood running cold on your skin? Do you hear their endless cries? Do you smell their putrid wounds? They were once brothers, sisters, and loved ones. And look at what you have done to them. All because you were a coward, because you ran from your curse instead of facing it. When you turned your back on your father, Zimbo, you turned your back on the gods and let the darkness wreak havoc on your people. Why must they pay for your heresy? hear the voice of your mother, Galina. She calls for you, Senua. Go to her. Answer her pitiful call.
Mother! I need you! Help me!
Against the darkness when it came forth. She too had a sight. She too doubted the gods and let the darkness infest her. But she didn't love you. She escaped the only way she knew how. She gave her life to the gods.
If only you had done the same, the world would have been spared this horror.
It's not too late. She's calling for you. Why don't you join her?
Thank you.
should suffer with your brethren and rot and let your blood seep into the seas and the rivers of hell. Isn't that what you deserve after all you've done? Give the darkness what it wants, let it swallow your soul and destroy all that you are. Why are you fighting for someone who is already dead? Just look around you. What hope is there for him, even if a soul could be rescued? Do you think he'd thank you for what you have done to him, to his friends, to his father?
Thank you.
fight it anymore. Not on my own. Where are you, Mother? I want to be with you.
That night, she gave up on her world to follow in the footsteps of her mother. To go to a place where the darkness couldn't reach her.
Senua, look at me.
Do you hear them? They're calling for me.
We've lost so many. And I've lost my father. I can't lose you.
You said it. I have blood on my hands.
I didn't say that. You've done nothing wrong.
Zimbal was right. Everyone will suffer.
Zimbal is a fake. He is a hateful, bitter liar. He's poison. And his words still haunt you. Who do you trust? Him? Or me? Do you still believe in Isenua? In us? Come back to me.
The hardest battles are fought in the mind. He gave her the sword with which to fight in more ways than one. She gave him her word, never to surrender. All she needed was a little help, a little hope.
Into the mountain.
Can you see it?
Shall we tell her where to go?
That's not far. Go on.
Look.
Up. Just up there. Listen to us. Is it? Shall we do it?
Shall we?
Does she know which way to look?
Does she know her way into the mountain?
She's a fool, isn't she?
There's a door.
You can do it. do it. You can see. Come on, Senua.
Go away. I'm not listening.
I'll tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf Rein. But Rein does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Rein's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Rein's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature. A dragon.
Feel it.
No.
Don't open the door.
No, go in. Don't
turn back. Turn back.
What's that?
Get back. A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name. And it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How would you say Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadows?
They can't stop me.
Then do it. The beast is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here.
Senua.
It's so loud.
It's not her.
So full of hate. I just want to help them. Tell me what to do. Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them. But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
and they want me with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen.
Do you see them?
Do you see their faces? Oh. He's coming! Senua! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Oh, where has she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold chill of fear. I don't talk much about her father. Zinbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
Rain the dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rain would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rain reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rayan go in search of Fafnir.
Oh, can't go anywhere without your light.
Take the torch and move. The blood.
Thank you.
torch is going out.
No, it's not. It's going to run out soon.
She hasn't got much time. She's too slow.
It's not going to burn out.
The darkness will come again.
She escaped the darkness, that she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
It's a trap. The beast is coming. A stupid little thing.
Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dewey.
He's always
watching you.
He's there. You're never safe from him. You can win. torch alight.
Finish this!
He was trying to save her from the darkness.
Zinbel was right. Zinbel was trying to save her from the darkness.
And now everybody is dead.
Because of her. She should have known. And she should have thought.
Why doesn't she learn? Well, she learns.
She doesn't understand.
Now the dark.
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of the woman who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
Once she gets down there, she'll never come out. It's luring her down.
The darkness will take her like it took her mother.
The beast knows. The beast knows exactly where she is. She's falling for it.
She falls for their tricks every time.
The lights run out. She'll die. She can't. She'll die. She has to. She can't. She's going to go through
Sigurd kills the dragon. Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.